بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Understand Al-Quran the easy way, course number 5, grammar with page 16, pointer A, that is grammar with 16A, lesson 16A. In this lesson, we will take introduction to Nahw and importance of Nahw and Jumla Fi'liya, a verbal sentence. Let's talk about importance of Nahw. Every verse of the Quran is a sentence. Therefore, in every line of the Quran, you will find these rules. You will get familiar with ending changes in words, and therefore it is easier to recite, and therefore you will make less mistakes during the recitation. Is it Jannatin or Jannatun? It is easy to understand the Quran if you understand the Nahw. There is less confusion in understanding. It is easier to memorize also for the same reason. Is it Jannatun or Jannatin? Or Ja'ala or Yaj'al or Yaj'ala or Yaj'ali, whatever. It is easier to memorize also because you will be familiar with the word endings, as we said it, Jannatun or Jannatin or whatever. It is easy to speak when you inshallah start practicing even speaking, less errors will be there. And you cannot progress in Arabic language studies without Nahw. It is easy to read Arabic books, and Arabic books generally don't have Fatha, Kasra, Dhamma. And most important part, or one of the most important part, is the more Nahw you learn, the better you will see the literary miracle of the Quran. You will be convinced that this book, the Quran, can never be compiled by a human being who did not even know how to read and write. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was an ummi. He did not attend any school, nor did he have any time to prepare and edit. Yet he delivered pages after pages in just one sitting. For example, in one sitting, like Suratul An'am. It is a life miracle. The Quran is a life miracle. And if we don't know Nahw, we are simply deprived from one more source of increasing our iman. So learn Nahw. There is a power and beauty in Arabic language in the way that the sentences are constructed. For example, if you want to say Khalid hit Zaid, you can write it in different ways. Daraba Khalidun Zaidan, or Khalidun Daraba Zaidan, or Zaidan Darabahu Khalidun. So you get huge flexibility, and that gives you a maximum power of expression. By having these strokes and then strokes at the end, like on, an, and so on, you make the language very brief. For some languages, for example, require additional words to show that it is fa'il or it is object, subject or object. Like in Urdu, we have to add ne or ko, but in Arabic, you don't need it. That on means subject, an means object. And also no need to stick the order. No need to stick to the order. Like in this slide, we have seen Daraba Khalidun Zaidan. Khalid hit Zaid. In English, if you change the order, khalas, you kill the sentence. You cannot say hit Khalid Zaid or Zaid hit Khalid. I mean, the meanings and everything will be gone. And that also again gives you a lot of flexibility. And that's why Arabic poetry is extremely powerful in balancing sentences. And it gives you a chance to emphasize. For example, if I say Khalidun daraba Zaidan, it means I know Zaid is hit, but who is that? So instead of saying it is Khalid who hit Zaid, I just put the word Khalid in the front. That's it. So instead of saying daraba Khalidun Zaidan, which is a routine sentence, if I said Khalidun daraba Zaidan, it means, well, it is Khalid who hits Zaid. So that, you know, gives you a chance to emphasize. In fact, you will learn a lot of these details in this course. When you explain, especially for teachers, when you explain Sarf and Nahw in the classroom, use the right side of the hall to explain the TPI of Sarf, like fa'ala, yaf'alu, if'al, fa'il, maf'ul, fa'il, and so on. And when it is Nahw, use the left side of the hall, or just change your position and explain like daraba Khalidun Zaidan and so on. This is in order to avoid confusion between the TPI of Sarf and TPI of Nahw. Remember, Arabic grammar is divided into two parts, Sarf and Nahv. Sarf and Nahv. And let's take very simplified definitions. Sarf is from the root letters of a verb like fa'ala, we can make different words like fa'il, fa'il, fa'altum, yaf'alun, and so on. That is sarf. Alim. And what is nahv? From different words, you can make, for example, simple sentences like al-baytu kabirun, or you can make pairs like fil ardi baytun kabirun, and so on. And using pairs and words, you make rather bigger sentences. That is nahv. But when you make sentences, the ending of words like a, I, u, or un, in, an, in, un, all these change according to their position as subject, object, etc. This is controlled by nahv. For example, khalaqallahu al-arda. So, u, a, etc. is controlled by nahv. In the last course, we learned jumla ismiya, nominal sentence. What is nominal sentence? Nominal sentence or ismiya is the one which starts with an ism. For example, al-baytu kabirun, the house is big, and both of them are in rafa' state, u-un. So you just show your hand pointing upwards as if they are standing. Okay, so repeat after me, al-baytu kabirun.
Al-baytu kabirun.
Allahu ghafurun.
Allahu ghafurun.
And we have al-muslimu sadiqun.
Al-muslimu sadiqun.
Al-muslimuna with four fingers now. Al-muslimuna sadiquna.
Al-muslimuna sadiquna.
Alim. So we learned this jumla ismiya, or these types of jumla ismiya. Let us now in this lesson learn jumla fi'liya or verbal sentence. Verbal sentence of fi'liya jumla is the jumla which starts with fi'l. It's very simple. For example, daraba khalidun zaydan. Hit khalid zayd means daraba khalidun, khalid hit zaydan. Zayd. This is a jumla fi'liya which starts with fi'l. Daraba. Very simple. Here khalidun is the subject because he is hitting and zaydan is object. Khalid is in state of rafa. Okay. That is rafa state, that's the default state, un. And zaydan is in a state of nasb. Nasb is the state which represents, for example, in this sentence, someone who is affected. To remember this, you can do this simulation. Simple one, use your two hands. Suppose this is Khalid, Khalidun standing, Zaydun standing. Now what is happening? Daraba, Khalidun is hitting, so watch out. Daraba Khalidun, zaydan. Now, don't let this hand also fall there. Huh? Just hit it and let this stand up. Keep standing. So, Zaraba Khalidun Zaydan. Now, Zayd is affected. So, this is in Nasb state. An. Okay. So, our simple sign for TPI is Rafa is like this. Standing, pointing upwards. And Nasb is lying down. Okay. A fallen finger, kind of. So, this is Rafa state. And this is nasb state, the affected state. So let us do this practice with TPI. Repeat after me. Daraba Khalidun Zaydan.
Daraba Khalidun Zaydan.
Okay, the secret is when you say Daraba, you don't show anything. Okay, Daraba is a verb. We are not showing. Now, this is also a Nahf TPI. So, in this Nahf TPI, we don't mix with all those fa'la, fa'lu, yaf'alun, ta'falun, daraba, yadribun. No. We are now doing the TPI for sentences. Okay, and those will be like this only. Nothing else. So, daraba, so you don't show anything. Khalidun, standing up, this is rafa state. And zaydan, that is nasb state. So, daraba, khalidun, zaydan, like this. So, repeat after me. Daraba, khalidun, zaydan.
Daraba, khalidun, zaydan.
Let's take some more examples now. First of all, translate them and then we'll do the TPI. Da'a Nuhun Qawman. Da'a Nuhun, Nuh invited, called upon or called them towards Islam. Da'a Nuhun Qawman. Nuh invited people. يدخل مؤمن جنة. A believer, يدخل مؤمن. A believer will enter what? جنة, paradise. يعمل مسلم خيرا. يعمل مسلم, a Muslim does خيرا, good deeds. Okay. Now, can you translate? دعا نوح قوما.
نوح invited people.
عليه السلام. يدخل مؤمن جنة.
A believer will enter paradise.
يعمل مسلم خيرا.
A Muslim does good deeds.
And also remember, in English, you cannot translate like invited Nuh people. So that may be confusing. So whenever you translate, keep the verb and subject together. So you will translate, if you want to break it to word for word, it will be like this. دَعَى نُوحٌ, Nuh invited قَوْمًا, people. يَدْخُلُ مُؤْمِنٌ, a believer will enter جَنَّةً, paradise. يَعْمَلُ مُسْلِمٌ, a Muslim does خَيْرًا, good deeds. This is the best strategy. Now let us practice the TPI. Okay. Repeat after me in Arabic. Da'a Nuhun Qawman.
Da'a Nuhun Qawman.
Remember, when you say the verb, you don't show anything. Only when you say subject and object, then you use your fingers. Next one. Yadkhulu Mu'minun Jannatan.
Yadkhulu Mu'minun Jannatan.
Jannatan.
يعمل مسلم خيرا.
يعمل مسلم خيرا.
Once again. دعا نوح قوما.
دعا نوح قوما.
يدخل مؤمن جنة.
يدخل مؤمن جنة.
جنة.
يعمل مسلم خيرا.
يعمل مسلم خيرا.
علم. Alhamdulillah. Now let's take another sentence, another example where we don't have tanween, we don't have un an, because we have al in the beginning, so un an will go. For example, Allahu al arda. Okay. So the example is khalaqa Allahu al arda. Now we will always translate verb and subject together in English, into English, so that English is not disturbed. If you say created Allah, the meaning may be somebody created Allah, astaghfirullah. So we have to say khalaqallahu, Allah created al-arda, the earth. Okay, translate khalaqallahu,
Allah created
al-arda,
the earth.
Khalaqallahu al-arda,
Allah created the earth.
Allim. The word Allah is subject here. As a sign of respect, we don't say Allah is subject, Allah is object. So we say word Allah is subject here in this sentence. So this is represented by Rafa, and Al-Arda is object. So let us do the practice with TPI. Okay. Khalaqallahu Al-Arda.
Khalaqallahu Al-Arda.
As usual, when you say the verb, you don't show anything. Okay. Again, Khalaqa Allahu Al-Arda.
Khalaqallahu Al-Arda.
Allim. Let's take some more examples now. First of all, let us translate. Hafiza al-Muslimu al-Qur'ana. The Muslim memorized the Quran. So we will take the verb and subject together. So translate. Hafiza al-Muslimu.
The Muslim memorized
al-Qur'ana.
The Quran.
Similarly. Yaqra'u al-Mu'minu al-Haditha. The believer recites the Hadith. So translate. Yaqra'u al-Mu'minu.
The believer recites
al-haditha.
The hadith.
The third one is yasma'u as-salihu as-sira. The pious person listens to the sira. So translate yasma'u as-salihu.
The pious person listens as-sira to the sira.
Once again, translate hafidha al-muslimu.
The Muslim memorized
al-Qur'ana.
The Qur'an.
Yaqra'u al-mu'minu.
The believer recites
al-haditha.
The hadith.
Yasma'u as-salihu.
The pious person listens
as-sirah
to the sirah.
Allim. Now let us practice these sentences with TPI. Again, for verb, you don't show anything. And for subject, you know, this sign and object, the other sign, standing finger and lying finger. So, repeat after me. حفظ المسلم القرآن.
حفظ المسلم القرآن.
يقرأ المؤمن الحديث.
يقرأ المؤمن الحديث.
يسمع الصالح السيرة.
يسمع الصالح السيرة.
علم. Once again. حفظ المسلم القرآن.
حفظ المسلم القرآن.
يقرأ المؤمن الحديث.
يقرأ المؤمن الحديث.
يسمع الصالح السيرة.
يسمع الصالح السيرة.
علم. Now, when you're doing like this, remember that is the subject. And you're doing like that, remember that is the object. Alright, by the way, we have been practicing it from the almost from the course one. For example, we are saying هل سمعت القرآن؟ نعم سمعت القرآن. So objects always were having this a. Now let us change the subject to plural. Okay. حفظ المسلم القرآن. This is singular. The Muslim memorized the Quran. The plural will be حفظ المسلمون القرآن. The Muslims memorized the Quran. Now you may be tempted to say حفظوا. حفظا is singular. حفظوا is plural. But in Arabic, if the verb and the subject حفظ المسلمون they are there in a sentence, then the verb is always singular. That's very interesting. So you don't have to worry about changing the verb. You don't have to worry about changing the first verb to plural. It is easy, therefore, to make a sentence. Just say حفظ حفظ. Just change the subject. Al-Muslimu, here it will be Al-Muslimuna. And when you're saying Al-Muslimuna, you will use four fingers. And this is in the Rafa state. Most plural of Muslim is Muslimun. Okay. So let us take some more sentences. يَقْرَأُ الْمُؤْمِنُ الْحَدِيثَ. The mu'min recites the hadith. The plural will be يَقْرَأُ will stay as it is. Mu'min will become mu'min. يَقْرَأُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الْحَدِيثَ. Third one, يَسْمَعُ الصَّالِحُ السِّيرَةِ. The pious person listens to the seerah. So يَسْمَعُ will stay as it is and only صَالِح will become plural. يَسْمَعُ الصَّالِحُونَ السِّيرَةَ. Right? When you stop, it will be السِّيرَةَ. But here, because we are learning the U and the A signs and so on, or the sounds. So let us say the ending I'rab or ending sign clearly, like السِّيرَةَ, الْحَدِيثَ, الْقُرْآنَ. All right, now give me the plurals with actions. حَفِظَ الْمُسْلِمُ الْقُرْآنَ.
حَفِظَ الْمُسْلِمُونَ الْقُرْآنَ.
يقرأ المؤمن الحديث.
يقرأ المؤمنون الحديث.
يسمع الصالح السيرة.
يسمع الصالحون السيرة.
Once again. حفظ المسلم القرآن.
حفظ المسلمون القرآن.
يقرأ المؤمن الحديث.
يقرأ المؤمنون الحديث.
يسمع الصالح السيرة.
يسمع الصالحون السيرة.
علم. Now let us change the subject to feminine. In case of feminine, for example, حفظ المسلم القرآن, the Muslim male has memorized the Quran. You have to change the verb also here in general. حفظت المسلمة القرآن. حفظت. هو حفظة هي حفظة. That was our صرف construction, okay? So she memorized. When you combine حفظت المسلمة, it will be حفظت المسلمة. But here, for practice sake, we'll read every word independently. So we'll say حفظت المسلمة القرآن. Okay? Similarly, يقرأ المؤمن الحديثة. هو يقرأ. So المؤمنة will be هي تقرأ. Okay, that was our surf signs, okay? The verb constructions. Alright, so it will be تَقْرَأُ الْمُؤْمِنَةُ الْحَدِيثَ. The mu'mina is reciting the hadith. Similarly, يَسْمَعُ الصَّالِحُ السِّيرَةَ. The pious person is listening to seerah. So what will it be? Tasma'u, huwa yasma'u, hiya tasma'u. Tasma'u salihatu as-sirata. The pious woman is listening to the seerah. And I will be using right hand for masculine and you will be using left hand for feminine, okay? And as we are reading in Arabic from right to left, so your sign will be right and left. Right and left. حَفِظَتِ الْمُسْلِمَةُ الْقُرْآنَ. So we don't confuse ourselves. حَفِظَ الْمُسْلِمُ الْقُرْآنَ. So we're going, you know, we're reading Arabic from right to left. So we will continue. حَفِظَتِ الْمُسْلِمَةُ. This is first word and the next word is next to that. So it will be shown like this. الْقُرْآنَ. I hope you are just following this. Keep the textbook in front of you and say, okay, حَفِظَ الْمُسْلِمَةُ الْقُرْآنَ. That's all. Okay. Change the subject to feminine and the verb also. حَفِظَ الْمُسْلِمُ الْقُرْآنَ.
حَفِظَتْ الْمُسْلِمَةُ الْقُرْآنَ.
يَقْرَأُ الْمُؤْمِنُ الْحَدِيثَ.
تَقْرَأُ الْمُؤْمِنَةُ الْحَدِيثَ.
يَسْمَعُ الصَّالِحُ السِّيرَةَ.
تَسْمَعُ الصَّالِحَةُ السِّيرَةَ.
ما شاء الله. Once again. حَفِظَ المسلم القرآن.
حفظت المسلمة القرآن.
يقرأ المؤمن الحديث.
تقرأ المؤمنة الحديث.
يسمع الصالح السيرة.
تسمع الصالحة السيرة.
علم. That's it for now. Jazakumullah khair. Inshallah, see you in the next class. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum. Learn to read Al-Quran. Learn Tajweed. Understand Al-Quran and memorize it using easy, scientific and interactive methods. Get ebooks, videos, audios, posters, PowerPoint files, app links for different courses. We have specialized Montessori materials and games for making the Quran easy for kids, and a teacher's resource center too. Get personalized one-to-one online courses that suit your needs from expert teachers. For free trial, write to admin@understandquran.com or visit understandquran.com. Wassalamu alaikum.